Well, the sudden passing of footy legend Paul Green has left the entire rugby league community mourning. Overnight, players pausing for a minute's silence to honour the NRL great. And Greeny's good friend and fellow NRL great, Wally Lewis, joins us now in Brisbane. Wally, look, I think this is really tough to get your head around this morning. Can I ask, how are you doing?
Yeah, well, like everybody else in Queensland at the moment, especially very hurt, very upset about it. It was shock to hear about Greeny. He's just one of those guys that always had a smile upon his face and always appeared to be quite comfortable with the realities of everyday life.
I mean, you haven't really found anyone who can say a bad word about Greeny. He's sort of loved by all across both sides of the border. I know he played, he coached, he loved the game. What are some of your greatest memories of him?
When he came along for the very first time, of course, he had a dream of travelling to Sydney to see whether his football skills were good enough to play in the best rugby league competition in the world. And he had that self-doubt about him. But the first opportunity that he got, he was playing for Cronulla, of course. Super League came about and he took part in a grand final against the Brisbane Broncos. So he went from a Brisbane hero to somebody from Brisbane that they didn't like all that much when he came home to make sure that the Broncos were handed a defeat. Unfortunately for Cronulla fans, that wasn't the case in Super League days. But he just went on to some wonderful things throughout the course of his time. And I remember...
I've lost him. Okay, I think we've lost Wally there. But, I mean, I know for me, just looking at those picks there too, Paul Green, that grand final win, the Cowboys, when it was JT who kicked the field goal in that golden point, it was one of the most extraordinary moments. But we know that Wally is really feeling that loss this morning. In fact, of course, Paul Green's family and the whole rugby league world, our thoughts are with them this morning. All right. Let's go to Carl.
Look, just on that too, Peter Dutton's joining us now, opposition leader. He's talking with Richard Miles, but you knew him, didn't you? And it was a big shock to everyone yesterday.
Oh, just shocking news. And, young kids, beautiful family, and was a legend of the game and just respected by everyone. And I think all of these, circumstances just shock people because, everything in his life, as Wally just said, I mean, it was all to play for and, whatever support could be provided to the family, I'm sure the rugby league community will.
You know, it was such a big thing for Townsville too. North Queensland climbed the mountain with JT and that side. And that was the most extraordinary grand final and one of the greatest sporting things I've ever seen. For him to help that side do that was really amazing.
As you were saying before, this was such a huge shock to everyone.
Yeah, it certainly was, Ali. Nobody expected to hear such tragic news. Of course, he played for five NRL clubs, so he spread his talents right across the National Rugby League. He coached Queensland in State of Origin. He got the opportunity to be able to be involved with a side that played in a grand final, Super League grand final. But he was just one of the guys, one of the real nice guys of rugby league that everybody appreciated any time spent in his company.
I mean, we're looking now at pics of what, for me, was, one of my great highlights, I think, in his career, which is, of course, when he was coach, the Cowboys grand final win. For you, some of the best memories?
Yeah, that was certainly it. It was at the top of the list, watching him, the thrill that was upon his face, knowing that, that they'd captured a title that everybody suggested was impossible for the Cowboys to ever come close to. The Cowboys got the opportunity to be able to celebrate for a week. They went right through the state, and even the most staunch Broncos fans and Titans fans in southeast Queensland were on board the Cowboys trip. It was certainly fantastic, and they got the chance to be able to hear from Paul about his dream. I'm at the club where he started it all off, at Winner Manly in Brisbane, and he had plenty of talents here. Everybody just predicted that he was going to go on to bigger and better things, and that was certainly the case.
I mean, I remember watching that grand final, a really dodgy connection with a 60 minutes trip in Tonga, and we had like the whole local community around us and everyone was going for the Cowboys. It was so special. look, there was a really beautiful moment last night. There was a minute's silence. That was ahead of the Panthers and Storm game, and I remember watching that and just thinking of his family in that moment. I know we're all feeling for them this morning. The rugby league world will surely wrap their arms around them, I assume, Wally.
Yeah, certainly. There's no doubt about that, Ali. They'll be wishing the best for his family, certainly in tragic circumstances, their parting. But it's one of those occasions that I think it's very important if you're doing it a little very tough in your life, just to take it on and seek help. It really is an important opportunity, I guess, to continue things in the best possible way. But Paul will always be remembered as a wonderful man that was quite prepared to do the best for the people around him, certainly in the rugby league game, and I'm sure his family going to struggle for quite some time. It really is a tragic loss.
Hey, Wally, beautifully said this morning. We really appreciate you coming on and sharing those memories. And as Wally just said, if you're struggling or know anyone who is, there is help available. You can contact Lifeline on 13 11 14.